to another segment of the Dr. Marge Show. Kansas City is getting ready to be involved in one of the greatest opportunities for our young people as it relates to golf. And my guest today is Ms. Sedina Parks, who is a member of the LPGA Golf Tournament, right? Or is it, what is the correct language for it?
I'm a member on the LPGA Tour.
She's a member on the LPGA Tour.
This program is brought to you by the Service Law Office, specializing in family and guardianship law.
I got that right for her. So Sedina's here in Kansas City, and she's been here talking to different people, talking about the importance in getting young people involved in golf at an early age. And let's start with that. It's my understanding you were about 9 years old when you first had an opportunity to swing the club, and your dad said, there's some talent there. I'm going to make sure that she's participating, that she's groomed, that she's moving forward. So what was that experience like for you?
At that age, you know, I was still playing basketball, running track, and playing soccer. And that was, you know, at that age, those are the sports that you're used to being involved with and you could relate to. Golf wasn't necessarily the sport that my first go-to, waking up in the morning is the first thing I wanted to do. So my dad really helped me understand the importance of the game. Not only that, I picked it up quickly, picked it up fairly fast, and he kept telling me and reminding me how important this could be for my future, making it a living. And you know, golf, as we know, is an expensive sport.
Yes.
But it's an expensive sport because it pays well as well. So. At that age, I still didn't quite understand, and as you know, parents know best, so he helped me understand, and I practiced every day. He helped me understand the importance of the game, the mental aspect of it all, and that's what I want to help the juniors understand, that this game can help you in all aspects of life, that can help you how to discuss things with yourself, making right decisions, how to be respectful of the golf course, and that's the same thing of how to be respectful of someone else's belongings or property or feelings. Anything that wraps in to the game of golf relates so much to things in your life, and you can grow faster as a human being, and you can relate to a lot of people around the world that love the game of golf. I mean, say, you know, up to the President of the United States or a CEO of Amazon or something or some sorts like that, you could communicate through this game and create great relationships and partnerships and make something of yourself.
Okay, so at the age of 9 is when you first had the opportunity to swing the club. From that point, your dad saw, I think I have something here, encouraged you to stay with the game, and as you continue to play from the age of 9 and going into high school, what was the experience like for you? Were there very many African-American young ladies who were playing golf?
You know, there is. Mm-hmm. There's a ton of African-American junior players out there. It's the ones that were interested in the game as much as the other things that they were doing in their life. But that's when I was associated with this league in Portland. And it was called, it was like a minority league. And there was tons of African-American women, ladies, boys, little kids up to almost going to college. So that's where I felt like I related. That's where it felt like I belonged. And that's when I actually took the game seriously, because when you're an athlete, you're competitive. So we were starting to compete. And I love going to practice every day. I love to be involved into something that seems like I was making progress in.
Okay, so why do you believe that we don't hear a lot about African-American golf? It's like, we know Tiger Woods. That's right. A name for us. We don't hear a lot about young ladies, African-American young ladies who are playing the game. And now your name is out there. Mm-hmm. And you're being able to encourage young people, as you call them, juniors, to participate in the sport. Because many of them may believe, well, if I can't play basketball, if I can't play tennis, if I can't run track, then there's nothing really for me. And this is a whole new world of golf that has not been touched.
Right, right. And you know, Tiger Woods has set a path for minority boys mm-hmm. to see that it is possible, you know, and not yet. We have Cheyenne Woods, you have Mariah Stackhouse, and you have myself that's on the LPGA Tour that is now showing that, you know, we are capable of being at the top. And not only that, we are still striving to be winners out there as well. But this game, as you said, you know, it promotes both. I mean, you could also be a great golfer, but if not, you have great access to individuals that are in the business that can help you get a job, help you get a job in something that you are quite interested in. Because everyone, I'm telling you, that is involved in the game of golf have a business of their own.
Okay. So was there something that happened in 2012 that qualified you to play at a certain level, or when you were in college or high school? Is there some qualifying factor that you have to go through, or do you just play and however you come out in the game is how they rank you?
I think I understand what you're asking. So 2012, I did now start telling the tournament, people were involved in the tournaments, that I was going to play as a pro.
Okay.
You could still play as an amateur and not receive money, but I was thought I was ready to turn pro, so I told them I do want to play as a professional so I can accept some cash. I was playing very well, top five in these mini tour tournaments.
Yes.
And I was like, well, what's the point of not cashing in the dough? So
right,
I decided,
right. How long am I gonna wait? How long am I gonna sit here
and not accept this cash? So now I finally turned pro, and I realized that I can actually do something great. So I continued my pro status, and that's how I'm here today.
So let's talk about your professional wins.
Okay, on the Symetra Tour, I played 1 year, struggled a lot, had a lot of improvement to be done, and then the second year I played, I won twice, and I got like five top tens, I believe, and that's how I earned my LPGA Tour card.
Okay.
Once you're top 10 on the money list by the end of the year on the Symetra Tour, which is the tour right below the LPGA, once you're top 10 on the money list, you earn your LPGA Tour card.
Okay. So that allows you to play in and compete in the tournaments for the big money?
Correct.
Okay. Yeah. That's where we want to go. We don't want to do the freestanding things that helps our skill set, which that is good, you know, that you improve your skill set, but you think you're ready to get out there and play in the big league and be able to see income come in for your skill set.
Yeah. I mean, it's time to make a living, right?
Yes,
you know,
yes.
I worked so hard, so it's time to now fund myself. You know, you could rely on your parents for so long. And now I decided that I wanted to make a living, and I wanted to make a living playing this game. I love the game. It has helped me as an individual, most importantly. I've learned a lot about myself. And I want to help others do the same.
Have you had words of wisdom to give to young people of color who may be struggling with which direction to go as it relates to sports and have not thought about playing golf but are pretty athletic? What would you say to them? How can they get involved?
To get involved in the game, I would have to say playing golf is important. Playing golf is valuable. The words of wisdom that I would give these junior golfers and to encourage kids to become a junior golfer is not related to golf. it's telling the kids that if they want to be successful in anything, I think this game of golf can help get them there. That's what's helped me as a person. I mean, you can go from, you know, LeBron James to a comedian as of Kevin Hart. Mm-hmm. You know, when you're coming to these clinics, you're making something that seems impossible happen. You know, a lot of these shots that you think that possibly can't go in the hole, if you want it enough and if you want to put it in the hole, you will do everything possible to do that. So I want to help kids be successful in every aspect of their life and anything that they do. And that's words of wisdom for the kids. Yes.
And so a gift to us from you was tomorrow. I know that you will be at Swope Park playing on the wonderful golf course that is located there, and that the young people from the greater Kansas City area, Kansas City Public School, the invitation has been sent not only to them but to other surrounding school districts, that if you have young people who are interested in the game, that Sedina is here and she's going to share some of those techniques, and they actually get a chance to play a little bit of golf. So we thank you for your time and coming and giving of yourself. Welcome to Kansas City, and I hope you enjoy the beautiful city while you're here. Get a chance to see some good things. I know that you have been busy today, but we appreciate you coming and giving back to our young people and letting them see that, yes, there's an opportunity for you, and you know the game. You're able to explain to them not only how to be successful in that particular area, but just how to be successful in life. So hearing it from a young person means a lot to another young person about what their capabilities are. So we thank you for being here, and we hope that you have a wonderful day. And I hope that the young people tomorrow who get an opportunity to meet you will walk away with something that they can hold on to as they move to the next level.
Thank you, Doc. Thanks for having me.
Oh, sure. I always close the show by saying that we always talk about how important change is, and we always know that change is inevitable. If we are excited about change, we know that we have to be the change that we want to see.
Funding for this program is made possible by the following sponsors and partners.